Hey everybody, Arco here, doing the third round of the main risk server 1v1 World Championship. In this round we are going up against General Elidar. And the settings, we are playing 4 games of Brazil Caps, manual fog as per usual. There's Elidar there, and we're wondering where to pick. And then 2 games of whatchamacallit, Dino World. That's the other one. Not entirely sure which cap area is correct with these blizzards. I'll just take something. General over here. And we'll see which one of these Elidar goes to counter. All right, he does go there. I gotta make sure to put a bunch of troops up here on this corner eventually. But for now, we'll just take some dead-end corners. This is one of those weird maps where it's not quite zoomed out enough. Just barely. let's see. Take that one. One of these. Yeah, just keeping our stuff connected over here seems okay. Pick down here. He's gonna pick one of these three locations as his cap in the center here. If I were to guess, it'd probably be Goiás. Not fully sure how to properly pronounce that, so I do apologize there. Okay. We're gonna split some off here. I'll make that a 19. All right, he didn't split any off, sure. Do we bait him into rolling that? Maybe we do. Keep the 19 there because his camp is currently disconnected from that spot. We'll see if he goes for the early hero cap roll or not. All right, he fortifies that all back. Which unfortunately means I think we have to do the same. Leave a two back there. Just in case he tries to break without using his cap, give him a 5-on-2 roll. Okay, he does. Close that spot. So ideally, we don't want to retake this. But if he's holding everything like that, I might have to. Okay, he's hiding his stuff back there. One, two, three, four, six, nine, 10. Yeah, we'll leave it like this. Right now, his cap is only locked to hitting our cap spot. See how many he places down here. Ooh. We do have a set. plus two there. I'm down to gamble on the 9 on 10. It's against the leader. It's against the leader. Why did I try that? We'll do. That instead. We get some of the dice back. All back to cap. So I think we can safely go from here then. Something like that. There, is he gonna go for the 41 or 48 on 31? Doesn't look like he is. Okay, no wild card. Plus two down there. Plus two for a leader there. Okay, let's see the roll he gets. 10 on 5. Ooh. Not good. gotta come up and break. Actually, I don't want to close that, so we'll just go from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I gotta hit him 4 times, though. Okay, lost two on the two. Trade on four, don't need to use it. Okay, we get the set on three. This cab is never really gonna be weak, though. So he is gonna be successfully outscaling us. On round nine, might be round 30 as a draw, depending on what happens. We'll see though. Lost nothing on our three. Down a bit KD wise. Not guarding with anything, so I can still safely just retake. Move that back. This is 12. Damn, we have to use this. That's a bit annoying. keys, so the plus two. No trade on three. Doesn't remove the bottom stuff, he's still just stacking strong. We do see him move that back. Set on four. What are the sets if we don't trade? 20 gets 25 on top of that, which isn't quite double. So I think that's above 50, though, so we'll see if he goes for it. Nice, plus two there. Now he's looking to remove me from the bottom. We have no set. So now I'm gonna have to come around and break. This way. Didn't lose too much overall. We have a trade on four. Okay, Lidar takes both bonuses. Had to break there because he put a three back there. I got an 87. So do soul. I'll do it like that. Yeah, this might be a drawn game unless he goes for a risky cap hit of some sort. We got a wild card back. Leaving lots of stuff here. /163 on 127 isn't worth it to do. He had the set on three to take everything back. Okay. So now it might be a bit of a problem. Now I'm gonna have to close my cap that way. Yeah, I'll keep that closed there. Just move it all back. I'm leaving that 4 means he has to come around, or likely use his cap to open this spot back up again. Unless a 6, 1, 1, 1, 1. Nah, can't go through the 4. He has to hit this spot. So I'll keep my cap open and ensure some cards. A nice riveting start to this game. Okay, I see what you're doing there. Ah, he finally got me on the bonus. 2 was enough. Okay, we got a wild card back. Round 21. So round 30 is the draw limit on here. I know it's kind of crappy. I may end up having to go for it, because I am going to be behind. Just leaving off-cap troops there. And not too many. Let's see. Of course, I lost a troop. And we'll do it like that. Maybe I shouldn't have hit the bottom here and left a bit more. But now he does have to break both of these bonuses. Think his best bet is a 6-on-4. Okay, closes that off. That's good. Does he have a trade on 4? does not. Wins the 6-on-4, so he will be ahead here. He's going to be setting in next turn. Might as well roll out some stuff. All right, we got a set on 3 if he tries to do a bunch of blocking. Let's see. On round 24. Getting really good dice still. Okay, only leaves 3 there. Left a 2 or 3 back there. /225 on 188 isn't a good roll either. Do something like that to try and keep that alive and guard this bonus. I think I chose the wrong cap spot for myself. Does he win the 7-on-5? Oh my god. Man. Okay. Well, he opens our 7 back up. Clear it up. And we have another set. Let's go. We can increase our chances for a draw. In this game that we likely should have lost. Let's see. Gonna what? In case he has a set on three, we go back. Wins the six on four again. Wins the two on one. Wins another two on one. Oh boy. Got a while for another set. Oh man. Yeah, this I'm glad there's a draw rule. Wait, he did that. Oh, that was round 30. He did that before round 30. I think he did that before round 30. I mean, I could technically try and claim that, but I'll just agree to him that that's a draw. All right. On to game number two. After the great draw battle. Where sets on three saved me from a loss. So the score going into game two here is 0.5 to 0.5. Oh my god. Now these are some interesting blizzards. This entire area is a 2-point hold. Wow, these blizzards make 2-point holds everywhere. This game is less likely to go the full draw distance. He's going to go for the 2-point hold there. Okay. All right, Elitar. The think we'll go here then to try and counter all this. We have to go here to prevent him from holding the bonus. He goes there, okay. Yeah, this game's gonna go a lot quicker. Yeah, because if I cap here in that bonus. Unless I cap here, maybe? That could be a play. I think we have to go there regardless. If I cap here and then put a small stack in the bottom right, maybe? I'm not liking it either way. We could make this a quicker game by just going here and see how much he splits. Because if he tries to guard this strong off cap, I can maybe steal the cap. We'll go with that. Because if I went here, he could pivot his cap to here and do a similar 2-point hold on all of this. Yeah, so this is technically better. Okay, he wanted to see. Oh, he wanted to try and predict any off-cap stacks I might do. Well, he can only fortify one of these back to his cap, actually. So this could be interesting. This could be an interesting first turn. Okay, so he's guarding that with a 13. And that with a 22. 42 on 22. 72. Come on. Ah, oh, what are these dice? 80. All right, we got the break. Ah, oh, and we lost a troop there, unfortunately. Right, time for more cap rolling shenanigans. Come on, lose a bunch. Oh, we only lost one. Fuck. I wonder if the original 72 was better to just try and take to get a possibly heroic roll there. Yeah, that's 100%, I'm pretty sure. Ooh, lost six though. He is holding that middle bonus. I have to break too much stuff. Yeah, I have to take back one of these caps and break two bonuses. Yeah, not gonna be possible, I don't think. All right, I have to get really lucky. I have to get a three for row here. Nah, that's game. Good game. Yeah, I had to get a three for row, lose none, and then break at least one of the, and then do a single dice to break here, single dice to break here. Too much for all of that. There we go. Unless I win these. Holy shit, I took two off. Right. Much quicker game that time. Leadart takes the second one. On to game number three. All right, game number three. We both went first once so far, but he's up 1.5 points to half a point. Let's see. I am now first, and oh boy, now I get a potential BS area here. So I think we take this spot first, forcing him here. And then now we take this cap spot. Yeah. And if only this blizzard was one territory down, then I'd have the insane 1 point hold. And it goes there. That's well played. I think we pick here to prevent the counter cap. Could potentially cap there. there. Start picking in our 2-point hold area. Some of those spots on the left there. All right, we'll go all there, making that a straight line. I'll be looking to stack down here, but put the cap spot here just to take out anything a leader leaves behind there. I have to connect myself a lot either way on any of these picks. Huh. Interesting. His 16 isn't open to us. Think we. Yeah, we still have to do that. a bit there. And a little bit off to the side. Was well played. Oh, we forgot to break the bonus. Damn, we go even on the dice, though, which is not ideal. Do that, force them to break this way. Oh, he's manualing the cap already. This is a leader we're talking about. So his dice might be able to save him here. Down to 25 on 20. 22 on 20. Okay, he's getting bad dice. Really bad dice. Wow. Brings it back to even. As long as it's even dice from here on out, I'm happy with that. Game of Lidar. Alright, so that's 1.5 to 1.5 now. On to the final game of these Brazil cap settings. Okay, final game on Brazil at least. He has to go first for the even turn order rule, and he does, and oh my god. What the actual insane blizzards. What the hell is this? It's a 2-point hold. Crazy 2-point hold. Okay. Weirdly enough, I might have to cap at the bottom to try and prevent all this. We'll see what he forces me to pick. Okay, he forces me to pick there. Amazing. Amazing stuff. I have to go there before he forces me to pick there. What the hell? This is so dumb. Oh, man. I mean, if I'm not capping down there, because he's likely gonna go here. And then if I cap down there, he just takes a bunch of this stuff. Ugh. Not a fan. Not a fan of this Blizzard setup. This is terrible. Oh boy. Think we're at the cap back here. That closes everything off. Ugh. Yeah, cat back here to prevent these from being held. And then a secondary stack up here, and just hope that he doesn't predict it correctly. This is a rough situation. Well done. Place just enough. He gets five, so it'll be a 21 on 20. It won't be a 100% roll. But he's getting like 60 to 70% odds to succeed here. Gotta hope he gets a crap roll. It's our only shot. Yes! Okay. We're still in it. We are still in this somehow. Okay, so we need maybe a troop here to do the two splits. And then we'll put the rest to here. There we lose a troop anyways. I'll do something like that. Back to camp. He gonna risk the 6-on-3 to break from this side and not have to close off his cap to mine? Damn, he does losing nothing. Maybe I should have made that a 5. That's what I should have done. Both our caps are gonna get weak, so this could weirdly still be winnable. Does he risk hitting my 2? He does, of course. Cap's getting a little on the weak side. Now we can come around through here, because he has to open my cap to break the bonus. We stop there. The 6. Completely forgot about his locked 3. He's going around, and then he'll use his 3 to take the bonus. Oh, what a weird game. We have a set on 3. If he doesn't have a set, and he loses a bunch on these ones, maybe. Sets on 3. He's going for my cap, 16 on 7. Ah, he barely wins. Almost pulled off the flip on that one. Yeah, maybe I attacked. I could have say, oh, I got bad dice on some of the rolls, but maybe I didn't need to hit some of the extra stuff. I could have hit just the ones instead of that 2, for example. But either way, GG's leader, so that is 2.5 to 1.5 going into the final 2 Dino World games. Alrighty, on to the final two games. It's Dino World, World Dom, Fog Blizzard, Stable Portals this time, along with the manual pick. Okay, Elidar gets to go first. So he goes first in this one, and that means I have to go first in the last game. So the Blizzard Portal combo isn't insanely overpowered for him, but it is still looking pretty strong. Think we might have to give him this and then take something like this while we can. It goes there. I'll go here. Taking one of those each. I'll pick this far spot over here in Australia. He continues that, so we'll stop it by doing this. Portals needs to lower a bit. So I think we will take that there. So we can, see the territory highlighting. It's very hard to see this territory, whether or not it's been picked. He goes there. We'll go here. Oh, he went up there. Okay. I'll keep picking in this bonus. Still hasn't been selected. Pick a bunch of spots up here. Potentially controversial pick, but I am gonna choose this one down here. What this tells Elidar is that because I own this bonus, On his first turn, he has to commit some amount of troops down here to break it safely. So when I stack somewhere in the north, he'll get less chances to roll my stuff. Take this middle spot. I need to turn it all the way down briefly just to see if he's picking this portal at all. He's not, so now. He takes two of the portals and I give him the last one. He takes that one. I give him that. Then here might be the obvious place to stack. So I'm going to stack over here instead. So I stack here and he stacks here. He still has this portal to break the bonus after getting the favorable roll. So instead, I'm going to go over here. Make sure the UI is up for this. Yep. Where I thought he'd go. And now my stack is open to his, so I need to make sure I follow it properly. He's gonna own this bonus. So I'm gonna have to commit a separate stack to break that. Fortifies where? He didn't break the bottom bonus. Interesting. Okay. This stack down here doesn't fully connect to mine if I leave this closed. So I am going to break from here, actually. follow him around. Because his stack isn't open here. Oh no, it is. It has the portal. Oh shit, I didn't see that. Okay, but he doesn't go for the full blitz, because then he'd leave me with some bonuses. Yeah, that's definitely... I definitely knew that. Okay, he failed the 3-on-1, so that's insane, actually, keeping me from having to break that. So we can break all of this. Sure. And now it's just a territory scramble. Nice. That's a crucial 3-on-1 fail as well. But either way, I have to go down here. Yeah. Yeah, I don't want to pivot there. Okay. He's only getting 4, yep. So we are ahead now in territories. He's saying good game, yes, okay. Very good game there. We tie the series up and we go first in the last Dino World game. 2.5 to 2.5. See who ends up winning the series. Alrighty, here we go. On to the final game. I have to go first. Let's see if we have to restart. Alright, we don't. Okay, these blizzards make the bottom area really broken. That is where we're going to open. There. I'll pick this spot, so he's going to have to pick one of these two. And he does. So we'll take this top left corner again. Likes that spot a lot. Go here. There's a generally good spot. This territory here does connect to that portal in the bottom left. Keep picking over here. Slightly better, I think, in that bonus. Okay, I'm gonna have to turn the UI down here just to see the portals here coming up, so I do apologize. I want to keep this spot as his so I could do the 2-point hold beginning. Alright, he does take it. Yeah, And we'll go up here. Yep, now we can turn the UI back up. Okay. Here we go. Nice, really good blitz. The leader gives up. There we go. We would have held the 2 point and knock him under there, so it would have been a really tough position for him to come back in. But nice. We get the 2 wins on Dino World, meaning the final score for this series is 3.5 to 2.5 in my favor. We did well enough to keep ourselves just above middle of the pack on the standings, I believe. So, still prime to hopefully catapult ourselves up to the top four area if we get a good score next week. But alrighty, GG's to Elitar once again. Round four will be sometime next week, of course, depending on the scheduling. And alrighty, GG's and take care, and cheers for stopping by.